Hello and welcome. I'm Jonathan Hunt, Corporate Vice President for Business Applications here at Microsoft, and welcome to AI in Action. This is where we unpack how AI, low-code, and other advanced technologies are revolutionizing the future of business applications. And today, I am super excited to welcome a special guest, Arnie Leap, CIO of 1-800-Flowers. Most of you likely know 1-800-Flowers is a global leader in the gifting industry, reaching millions of customers worldwide through their extensive portfolio of brands. Everything from Harry and David, Cheryl's Cookies, Personalized Mall, The Popcorn Factory, and more. And what I appreciate most about their company is how they've embraced technology to drive a culture of continuous innovation and continuous reinvention. So welcome, Arnie. Thank you for making the time to speak with us today.
Thank you, Jonathan. It's great to be here.
So let's go ahead and jump right in. Maybe you can just start by telling us a little bit about the history of 1-800-Flowers and your role at the company.
1-800-Flowers has got a rich history. It started with the founder, Jim McCann. A little over 40 years ago, Upper East Side, one floral shop, grew into a multi-billion dollar company, allowing our customers to express themselves with gifting with their loved ones and close friends. And so today, we're proud to have a wonderful portfolio of brands, as you mentioned, Harry and David, Cheryl's Cookies, 1-800-Baskets, Sherry's Berries, to name a few, the Personalization Mall, as well as Things Remembered as a recent acquisition of ours. So we're always looking for the next innovative, great idea to allow our customers to express themselves with loved ones and close friends. And the idea here is, you know, technology is a very large part of what the company views as a tool to help our customers express themselves. So along with that, over the course of the 40-year history, 1-800-Flowers was the first commerce store in America. And over the course of my tenure, the last 11 years or so, we coined early something called conversational commerce. And it was about the ability to communicate via messaging with our customers. Over the course of history here in the last 6 or 7 years, we start to realize that how AI has recently accelerated that capability and how our customers have really embraced it. So we're super excited about what's next, but the journey so far in the last couple of years with cloud and AI, our partnership with Microsoft, it's been super exciting and never a dull moment.
Fantastic. Thank you, Arnie. I mean, what an incredible history. And it, as you mentioned, it's been intertwined with your history of being technology forward. And as part of that, you've been leading the way with Microsoft solutions, including Azure Communication Services, Dynamics 365 Contact Center. Maybe just spend a minute or two sharing why you decided to bet on Microsoft and what you're expecting out of that journey.
I would say that this was a very strategic decision that was leading up to over the course of a couple of years. Certainly, everybody's paying attention to how fast AI and large language models have taken the world by storm here in the last 2.5 years. And over that time, we have had multiple generations of our chat capability and conversational commerce implementations. And we took a keen interest in Copilot very early on when Microsoft announced it. And that was the beginning of the decision-making process about what's next with Microsoft's portfolio. We engaged Microsoft, and it was January of last year for the Dynamics platform and the customer care aspects of it. And then by the time we got to May of last year, we had made the decision to move forward with the Dynamics Contact Center. And within 5 months of signing, we were able to deploy the Dynamics Contact Center within our entire enterprise supporting all brands.
It's fantastic.
And it was a pressure cooker for sure, but I think the collective teams did an outstanding job.
Yeah, right on. And that is impressive and well done by your organization in moving so swiftly. Obviously, 1-800-Flowers has an incredibly seasonal business based on holiday demand. This was the first holiday that you were on the Dynamics platform. Can you share a little bit about how that went and how the platforms changed the way that you guys do business?
This is not the first time we've transitioned our customer contact center software platforms over the course of my tenure. So we were well prepared to ask the right set of questions at the mm-hmm. right time, working with our business partners to make sure that everything is in front of them that they can see. We were answering our first set of phone calls in the first week of October, and were able to support our largest holiday, which is the Christmas holiday, mm-hmm. Where the platform performed. It did what we needed it to do. It gave us that first set of feedback of things that we needed to do in fast follows, and making sure that we wrap those up, because we do actually have a fast follow. When we get done with December, we're right into Valentine's Day, early part of February. So there wasn't a lot of time in between the two. We did some fast follow work. We got to where we need to be. The platform did exactly what we needed to do. And what's fascinating about the rotation of the platforms is our aperture on ideation of what to do next and how to support the customer is tenfold. And that's the exciting part, is like, oh, well, we can do this and we can change this and we can move this around. And it's more configurable than customization. I'll give you an example right during the middle of the holiday. A decent amount of phone calls coming in the November, early December timeframe, right at the peak of the holiday. Orders are coming in at, you know, record paces. And so it got to a point where we wanted to make sure we were prioritizing a certain set of customers because we saw some certain things in our supply chain. And so we were able to adjust rules on the fly.
Wow.
To route calls and make certain determinations of those calls and that those inbound calls to service our customers in ways we were never able to adjust for in the past. And that was just the beginning. I think since then we've introduced another dozen or so of those types of rules. And we expect that over time now, they'll become automated and we won't need an agent to support it. So it's super exciting to see how the groundwork was laid out, how the foundation was set up. And then more importantly, the ability to take advantage of what was considered major portions of the product. So we're super excited.
That's fantastic. And it sounds like the agility that you've been able to move with is a step function perhaps from where you were in the past, which is amazing, and a credit to you and the team. So you're now through the implementation, the decision-making, the implementation, you've gone live, you've gone through some of your seasonal peak volumes. As you look back, a lot of companies are trying to figure out where they get started and how to go about transitioning their organizations. What advice do you have for other leaders looking to implement and scale AI across their organizations?
We look at it as an accelerator, not an end all, but an accelerator. And to be more efficient in decision-making. And, you know, some old sayings come true over time. And one of them is garbage in and garbage out.
Yeah.
Right? And so AI is supposed to be intelligent, artificial intelligence. But if you feed it a lot of bad data, you're going to get some really bad answers. And so one of the things that we embarked on, and it was sort of, you know, do the right thing just because. And it's one of those, you get a little payback, you get your return on investment, and you don't necessarily see it right away. And you have to have that intestinal fortitude to just see these things through because you believe you're doing the right thing. One of those areas in an e-commerce business such as ours, data is everything.
Everything.
We have a tremendous amount of data. I would say there's a multitude of enterprise data lakes here at 1-800-Flowers. And that federation of those data lakes was the beginning stages of the ability to then curate data, to train models, to give us specific responses that we needed to support our customers. And so early on, 8 years ago, we mentioned, you know, we were into conversational commerce. What did that really mean? That meant that we wanted to have a chat conversation with our customer. And this was the early stages of that. And we've had five generations of that chatbot, if you will, over the course of about 8 years. So when these LLMs started coming to fruition, the one thing it solved for was is the natural language processing, the ability to start to capture the intent of statements being made and the ability to drive that. Once you had the intent state, it is incredible how quickly, if you have the right data in the right place at the right time for the right person or process, how easily you can start to federate and move these models forward throughout your processes and capabilities within the organization. We want to make sure we have the right information. We want to do the right thing by our customer. Mm-hmm. And so all of those cultural aspects help drive this innovative capabilities where we now leverage these assets in ways that a lot of people dream. So to your original question and to your answer, what makes AI accelerate a business? It's data. You have to make sure the data is, I don't want to say certified, I don't want to say verified, I want to just say good. The data has got to be good because it's ever changing, right? And then all of a sudden you get really good at structured data, and then you're having these weird conversations about what unstructured data could be used and how that works. And just in the last year, the services and the models, Copilot, and the capabilities that it has to be able to ingest unstructured data in ways we've never seen before, is just fascinating to see how fast the progressions are occurring. And the idea is to be able to prep that in advance. And Microsoft's been a great partner as it relates to Copilot and the things that we're doing internally to make data available in ways that we've never dreamed before.
I think it's a great message, and you summed it up well, saying garbage in, garbage out. The AI is only as good as the data upon which it reasons. And we've seen that with some of the new technology, companies are able to actually clean their data a little bit more effectively, structure a little bit more effectively, and then ultimately use that data to drive insights to help their customers as they go through their journey. So yeah. I think that's a great message you're sending here.